Greetings. Today I thought to elaborate a bit on the film V for Vendetta since it's the 5th of November. That was at least my initial plan, then I thought to transform the video topic into talking about liberal hypocrisy when it comes to freedom of speech. So anyone who's watched V for Vendetta, it's a good enough film, a bit childish at certain parts, you know, the obvious comparisons between Germany during the Second World War, etc., and some of the characters are a bit too evil, so to speak, and it's a bit exaggerated in certain ways. But the very interesting part, and something that you should definitely talk to normies, liberals, and leftists about, is that the film itself is supposed to be a critique of ultra-conservative or ultra-right-wing regimes. That's the villain they are portraying in the film, and that's supposed to be a cautionary tale of what happens with a ultra radical right regime or something like that. Now, the fun thing is that if you look upon this film, the 1984 sort of society that they portray in the film, and then you compare it with Great Britain as it is today, I can tell you this much. There are, at the moment, as I make this video, the 5th of November 2018, there are guys who are still in prison, who have been in prison since 2016. They're still in prison because they were part of a youth organization called National Action. Now, what did National Action do? Yes, they were distributing flyers, they were putting out stickers, and they demonstrated. Some of the guys, they have been arrested and put in prison because they found Julius Evola books in their homes. I have plenty of Julius Evola books in this very library. So if you want to talk about a suppressive regime, you don't need to go to V for Vendetta, you don't need to go to 1984. If you are in Britain, you can just point to your own regime, and then you can ask your liberal friends, if you still have those. I don't know why you would, but in case you do, if you have any normling friends, if you have any liberal friends or any leftist friends, you can ask them, okay, cool, can you please watch this film and ask, is this reasonable? Or have you read 1984? Is this reasonable? And they will probably say, no, that's so horrible, we must never get there. And then you say, okay, but can you promote this sort of politically incorrect views in public and see what happens? And this is not only the case in Great Britain. We've had cases in Sweden where you get dragged to court for saying mean things to people, basically. And that is, I can't even describe what the law says. It's called hets mot folkgrupp, which means incite against ethnicity, basically. And that can mean exactly anything. You can say whatever you want, and someone else can make an accusation against you. So it's really back to the 1600s with the witch hunts. It's truly remarkable and it's truly horrifying. So if you have any normling friends, talk to them, ask them to watch a film and say, okay, is this reasonable? They will say no. Then you say, okay, but we're not far from this right now because we have people in prison for the vicious crime of owning books and participating in the metapolitical game. So my point really is that the liberals try to portray a right-wing regime as something that would be overly authoritarian, but in all actuality, they are the ones who are cracking down upon freedom of speech, etc., and who are persecuting political dissidents. So if you believe that Great Britain, for example, or Germany or Sweden are some paragons of liberal democracy and freedom, then you're very much mistaken indeed. You're not a free society if you get put in prison for expressing your political views. XOXO, boom.